Hello friends, in this tutorial we'll be fixing the issue. Your phone is a cell phone turns on and off. It's automatically. So if you follow some of the guides in this tutorial, I hope it is helpful. So the first thing that you're gonna check is your battery. So cell phone battery, guys, you can see it's a cell phone and you have to check the battery. Sometime your cell phone battery will be either it's a low or damaged. So either check your phone replacing with another battery. If you do not fix, proceed to the next step. Okay guys, the next reason is you'll be playing the happy games in your cell phone. When you play the happy games in your cell phone, your cell phone gets it's a high temperature. Because of the high temperature, it will turn off automatically. So it is. It just happens in the some phone. It is a some rare case that your phone will switch off automatically when you play the happy game or some other reason while charging or while doing several other work, playing videos or listening to the song. If your mobile gets heated a lot, your cell phone will get automatically turned off. And let me proceed to the next solution. Next reason is your RAM and CPU. So if you're installing lots of application in your cell phone and your cell phone has a very less RAM, you run lots of application in a background and you'll face this issue because of less RAM and less storage. So some application either you have to uninstall or you have to use the less application according to the how much RAM you have in your PC or how much storage you have in your PC. So do not fill it up completely. Some part you just leave it free. That's the one reason your mobile gets turned on and your again it gets turned off automatically. The next reason why your phone gets turned off, you go to the setting and display. Inside display, you'll see here you have a screen timeout. So screen timeout, sometime in the beginning it will be set to 15 seconds. So even for the 15 seconds, if you do not use your phone, your timeouts and your phone will be locked again. So you'll find the phone in a lock condition like this. So again you have to press this and again you have to use the pattern to unlock the phone and then you can unlock your phone. So this is not a completely switch off of your phone. This is not because of any kinds of damage, but this is just some changes that you need to make in the setting. If you choose 30 minutes, now after 30 minutes only, your phone will get locked again. So that is a kind of just it get off from the screen. You can change this setting in a display. So if you do not have a lock screen option over here inside setting, you can get inside. Sorry guys, if you do not have a display setting inside setting, so inside settings I have option over here display. So if you do not have option over here display, or if you do not find anywhere screen timeout setting in a display, you just get inside lock screen and the password. Somewhere there will be lock screen and the password. To get inside that and find somewhere anywhere in the settings you have a screen timeout option, get inside different folder. Different phone has a different kinds of arrangement. So the another reason why your phone gets switched on and off automatically is some of the faulty app. If you have some kinds of app which is not good for your phone, or it uses more RAMs when you launch it, or see it causing some issue to your phone. See if it has some kinds of virus or it do not support your phone. So some of the applications, that's a faulty application, some of the application that is almost like a virus that is causing an issue to your phone. So you just have to find that particular application as soon as possible. You just have to uninstall from your phone, or you can just use antivirus to scan your system. You can download a lots of free antivirus on a Play Store, or you can just manually download from the internet for your phone and you can just install it. Next thing is, make sure you are not using any application for scheduling the automatic power on and off. Some phones do have a feature, some phones do not have a features that you can turn off and on your phone automatically. So you have made some changes in the settings somewhere that you are just automatically turning your phone on and off. You are scheduling your phone for automatic turn and off, on and off. So make changes in that settings. Maybe somewhere by mistake you have made a changes and you have forgotten it. So if you have done not done that, not a problem. But if you have done that and if you have forgotten, you can just check it out once. So the next thing that you can do to fix the issue is, you can see guys, here it is. You can get inside the setting in your phone, and at the bottom you'll find it's a software update. So somewhere you'll find in a setting, get inside the software update and check for the recent update. You can see it's a download and install update. So you can download and install the recent update and see if it fixes the issue, because updating has a lots of security and it fixes lots of your phone issue. So update your phone once and check if it is working fine. So the next thing that you can do guys, in your phone, get inside the setting and somewhere you'll find inside the setting backup and restore. So get inside that several folder, somewhere you must find it. So here is in my phone, it's account and backup. So inside my account and backup, here I have a backup and restore. So in your case, somewhere in your setting, you're going to find as a way to restore your factory, restore your phone. Somewhere you'll find in a setting. Check inside every folder. So here it is, backup and restore. So I'll tap that. Inside that, you guys are going to see here I have an option. So I got an option whether I want to backup my data and restore the data. If you have lots of important file, either you can move to the memory card, because it's going to wipe out everything. You will not have anything in your phone, in your cell phone. It will be like a newly purchased one. So backup all to the memory card, or you can just backup your data into your some Google Drive or anywhere. And then after restore the data, click on restore the data and it's gonna ask you. Okay guys, some new phones, it's gonna ask you for the sign in option. So you can just sign in with your Google account, or if you have a Samsung account, if you have created, you can create and you can just sign in with your account and you can just factory reset your phone. So that happens only for the new launch phone. You can see some of lots of the phone has a factory data reset option at the bottom. So when you click on that, you're going to see reset device. Now just click on erase everything and everything will be erased. So all the phone has the same procedure. Some of the phone you just have to sign in and go through the account. So almost all the phone you have to sign in, but some of the phone requires some of the new features, latest launch phone wants you to sign in again. So just do that. Even factory resetting your phone do not work. Power off your phone. So the next thing you can do is try hard resetting your phone. So you can say it's a wipe data, factory reset. So how do you get this screen? I told you, switch off the phone. As soon as you switch off the phone, it depends upon phone. In some phone, you're going to press it's a power button and home button. Some phone, you have to press the volume up key, power key and home button together. Just press the button together. As soon as you see any Samsung or any brand logo, you just remove the hand from the power button, and then after when you see the Android screen, you just have to remove the hand from almost all the button. So let me show you. Okay guys, you can see the phone is switched off. It's a volume up button, it's a home button and it's a power button. So all three button, I'm holding the volume off button, now I'm holding the power button, now I'm holding the volume off button, I'm holding the home button and keep on holding, and then now I'm going to press the power button. Now I'm holding all three button. As soon as this logo appears, leave the power button. As soon as you release your hand from the power button, you'll see this logo. When you see this logo, release your hand from other two button. Now wait for a while and you'll see the hard reset screen. So it depends on phone and brand. So you can check on Google if you have to press different other key in order to get the option for the hard reset. So now you can use volume up and down key to move up and down, and you're going to choose the wipe data factory reset, and you're going to press the power button over here for OK, and you can hard reset your phone. So there's another thing you can do. In a while your phone will reboot and like it will be like a newly purchased one. You're gonna have to log in with your Google account once again. So still the problem exists. So it is a very rare case. Your phone protective case will be causing the issue sometime. You'll be using, instead of soft, you'll be using a very hard case, and it will be so tight, and when you have the phone, you'll be see it will be so hard, and sometime it get pressed automatically and your phone will be switched off. So it turns on and turns off again. You'll turn on and again it will turn off again. You'll turn on and again it will turn off. So check your protective case. Maybe sometime your protective case will be causing issue. It's a very rare case. Sometime your power button will be damaged, and sometime when you press to turn on the phone, it will be stuck over here like this. So you might not notice. So make sure your power button is also not stopped. So you're going to check your phone from every point before you go to the nearby store for fixing the hardware issue. So the next thing you can try is, guys, installing the new Android software into your phone. So if you guys do not know how do you install, how do you flash the ROM, how do you install the firmware, how do you reinstall the Android operating system into your phone, follow the link in the video description. So if you know, you can do it. If you do not know, even you can contact your friends, or you can go to the nearby store or service center, or you can just follow the link in the video description in order to get some help and do it on your own if you want to try it. Anyway, if you are not being able to do it on your own, you can go to the nearby service center or store. So installing the new ROM, installing the flashing the ROM, or installing the firmware, installing the new you'll just delete it and install the new Android operating system again into your phone. So doing that is the next thing that you can try in order to fix this issue. So you have checked everything almost. You have checked the battery, you checked the whether you have done set the phone to auto off or not. Almost everything. You check the software issue. In every aspect, in every way, we check the software issue. So none of these is helpful, guys. Even you are not being able to install the ROM, and maybe because of the hardware issue, maybe there are some internal hardware issue. So either you just contact the near around the hardware technician to fix the issue. Otherwise, you just have to change the phone. There's no other way. Doing all this also not fixed. Contacting the near is by a hardware technician. If any kinds of hardware issue, they can fix. So in most phone, in most case, you cannot fix the hardware issue. Doing all this also do not help. You have to change to the new phone. If someone is able to fix your hardware issue and you are being able to use, very good thing. So these all are the different solution that you can try in order to fix this issue. If your phone is automatically getting switched on and switched off, or your phone is just getting turned off. So all these are the different reasons, guys. If you like this tutorial, be sure to hit the like button, subscribe and comment. I'll catch you in the next tutorial. Have a good day.